In April of 2019, scientists unveiled the first image ever taken of a black hole. The photo of the supermassive black hole M87 star was possible thanks to the Event Horizon Telescope, or EHT. Comprised of 8 radio telescopes around the world working together, the EHT is effectively a telescope the size of the planet. But M87 star may have layers that are yet to be seen, and taking a snapshot may mean extending the EHT's footprint beyond that of Earth. As you probably know, black holes get their name because they're so massive that light that crosses the event horizon can't escape their gravitational pull. They are, by their nature, invisible. So, technically, we didn't really take a picture of a black hole, but rather its shadow. We can, however, see what's outside the event horizon. In fact, that area can be very bright, as matter being pulled into the black hole rubs together, gets superheated, and gives off electromagnetic radiation. The hottest part of that so-called accretion disk is represented by the orange halo in the famous photo of M87 star. Knowing the size of the black hole's shadow against the accretion disk can help determine its mass of the black hole, and currently, the EHT is accurate to within about 10%. But between the accretion disk and the black hole's shadow, Einstein's theory of general relativity predicts there is another layer, called the photon ring. These photons pass the black hole at just the right distance and inclination to orbit it before escaping and reaching an observer. Really, the photon ring consists of an infinite stack of subrings, each ring getting sharper and fainter. Photons that have orbited the black hole more belong to higher numbered subrings, so the first subring is made up of photons that have made at least one half an orbit of the black hole. Subring 2 is made up of photons that have made at least one full orbit before escaping, and so on and so forth. Each successive ring is made up of photons that were shot into an exponentially narrower window. Imaging these rings would be yet another feather in Einstein's "I was right about general relativity" cap, which at this point must look like a peacock. It would be the first time we've seen space bent so much that it curves light into complete loops. But they would also give us more useful information about the black hole, providing a better estimate of its mass and telling us information about its spin as well. So, now the question is, how do we go about detecting the photon ring? If we've already made a telescope the size of the whole Earth, what's next? Well, making one bigger than Earth, obviously. It was once thought that meaningfully upping the EHT's power would require putting many instruments in orbit, but astronomers were surprised by how strong and clear the signal from M87 star's subrings were. They have since proposed that the EHT's resolution could be dramatically increased with just one instrument, even one that's piggybacking on another mission. And the farther away that instrument is, the more powerful the telescope becomes. One placed in low Earth orbit could detect the photon ring's first subring. If it was on the moon, detecting the second subring would be possible. Over a vast enough distance, the EHT's resolving power could be increased 100-fold. My nerd heart is already all aflutter imagining the pictures we could take with 100 times the power of the telescope that first photographed M87 star in 2019. But we may have to wait a bit longer. Even if everything goes well, the EHT may not get a space-based component for another decade. Once that's in orbit, we'll have our chance to confirm another prediction of general relativity and see light that walked on the very edge of a black hole. And this time, nobody better say it's blurry. While the EHT may not be expanding into space for a while, there are plans underway to add more Earth-based telescopes to its arsenal. M87 star is also shooting out gigantic jets of matter at almost light speed, and we've taken some stunning pictures of those too. For more on them, check out my video here. Thanks for watching, be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on Seeker.